Joining us now, she's a graduate of Stanford University and UCLA, got an MBA in business, and she is the founder and senior analyst at Wealth Management of Long Beach. Saving more homes than the fire department, well, more black homes anyway. Marie Deary is joining us. Good morning, Marie.
Good morning, Dominique. Good morning, Front Page family.
It is certainly my hope that people will call. A lot of times when you're on, people don't get up their nerve to call until the very end of the show. So we decided you'd stick around for longer today to give people time to get courageous and call, whether you're struggling with your, you know, mortgage, trying to figure out how to deal with that forbearance that's hanging over your head. We mostly want to focus on the resources available for people that are struggling with the pandemic, particularly this state bill that has just been signed by the governor. But we can also answer your questions, well, Marie can, about the Paycheck Protection Program, the EIDL loans, and anything else in between. So, Marie, let's talk about the state before we end up sidetracked with something else, because there's a lot to get sidetracked with. I mean, Biden just, you know, got his big bill passed through the House. Presumably,
Hooray.
It'll squeak by the Senate. Probably Kamala, Vice President Kamala Harris will step in like a superhero and be the tiebreaker in the Senate. But the one in the state has already been signed, right? So that's in motion.
Right, right. Governor Newsom signed the state stimulus for anyone earning $30,000 or less. They will receive a $600 stimulus help. The only requirement is that they have to file their 2020 taxes. And so that's good for especially for low income. They are go ahead.
No, go ahead. I don't want you to lose your train of thought.
Yes, you know, it's great for low income. It's $30,000 or less, and they must file their 2020 taxes. So if you do not have your 2020 taxes, now is the time to file your taxes. If you haven't filed your taxes in a long time, don't worry. You can go to anyone to file your 2020. If you don't have someone that you can call, you can always call my office and I will be more than happy to do that for you. So you can get that $600, you know, to help pay your utilities. It comes in handy.
So if you're making $30,000, is that for one person? Oh, you know what I'm saying? Sometimes I say $30,000 for a family of four. Is it $30,000 for one individual? Is there a different amount for if you have kids? How does that work?
It's a family. It's a household. So if you have two people or three people in the household, it's per social security number. So if you have a family of four, it is still 600. I don't think.
No,
I'm saying,
is it still 30,000? That's what my question was.
Yeah, you know.
So if you have four, a family of four, it's still $30,000 a year.
It's still 30,000.
That's it's hard to live. I mean, I know a lot of people are doing it. Don't get me wrong, but. So that's, you know, even if you have a family of 20, you still have a $30,000 limit and you're still getting one $600 check. But hey, we'll take it, right?
You know, the goal is, it's not, the intent is not that you would live off that $600. The intent is that it will help. It can help.
No doubt. That's a bill or two for sure.
Exactly.
All right, I just want to be clear. In order to qualify for this, all you have to do is file your taxes. You don't have to fill out any paperwork, go to a website, nothing like that. Just get your 2019s done, and it'll automatically come to you if you're making $30,000 or less a year.
Right, because when you file your taxes, you file your state. And so one of the stipulations is that you must file your state taxes. So the Franchise Tax Board will get a copy of your state, and you will get the money based on your state return.
Right, but most people who are making $30,000 a year are not going to owe taxes.
Well, no. They whether or not you owe taxes, you will still get the money. So it's based on...
I'm just saying, because if people haven't filed their taxes and they're scared to do so, I mean, if you are making $30,000 a year or less and you have a family, you probably don't owe back taxes. So that wouldn't be a reason to stop people from filing. Like, it's just that a lot of people are behind on filing because they haven't gotten around to it.
Yes, the priorities. They somehow don't put the priorities on their taxes. They don't know that the money they make, they have to file taxes. There are many, many reasons, Dominic. People.
And you've heard all of them, haven't you?
You've heard them all.
Yeah, you heard them all.
I've heard it all.
But if I'm a really low income person and I haven't filed my taxes for a long time, because I know you run into people all the time that haven't filed their taxes in 5, 7, 10 years, and you get people caught up. Because if you're not caught up, you're not in compliance, which means you're actually, if you ever make a bunch of money, they can take it. You can have all kinds of problems. So it's better to even just file it. You're going to do it for not that much money. If they're a low income person, you're not going to charge them tons and tons of money to get caught up on their taxes.
No. And so what I tell people is that if you have not filed for a long time, at least go ahead and file the last 2 years. So file 20, which is this tax year, and 2019. At least file those 2 years. What is going to happen is that you will get a letter from the Franchise Tax Board that says, well, you owe. Now, if you owe taxes, you will get a letter from the Franchise Tax Board. If you do not owe any taxes, then they're not going to bother you, because you don't owe any taxes. So not filing does not mean that you owe taxes. Not filing says, okay, you are not in compliance. Maybe you got a refund some years, but you lost that because you have not filed.
Oh, so you won't get a back refund. If you haven't been filing, you lost your opportunity to get your money back?
Yes. After 3 years, you lost that refund.
Oh, wow. Okay, I didn't know that. And so the first thing to do is at least file the last couple of years in tax filings. If you do that, they're not going to suddenly get mad at you because you're missing the ones from before 2019?
Well, all they will ask you to do is, okay, then you're going to get a letter from the Franchise Tax Board that says you owe 2 years of taxes. You owe for 2007, you owe for 2013, or you owe for 2015. And if you have not been making any money, that's not a problem.
Right. Okay, so let's give out your number one time right now, because I want people to do this while they're thinking about it. We need to get on this. It's really worrisome how many of us haven't filed our taxes, which means we're not getting the $1,600, we're not getting the $1,400, et cetera, et cetera. So let's give your number one more time, or one time.
Okay.
Right now.
Okay.
100 times.
562-427-8877. That's 562-427-8877. And, you know, Dominique, the problem that I encounter in trying to help people, especially with the PPP, is that there are so many small businesses that's out there But the problem is they're operating their business every day.
Right.
But they're
right.
not filing taxes.
Yeah, and we're going to get to that. We're going to get to that because I want to break down the personal and then go into the business. But first, I want to go to the phones real quick, if you don't mind, Marie. It's Radio Free 102.3 sure. KJLH, Compton, Los Angeles, Long Beach, and Inglewood. Gloria from Wilmington, good morning.
Jumbo. I wanted to ask Marie, my niece doesn't file taxes, but she only makes about $12,000 a year. How much is it to not have to file taxes? You know, like if you make $30,000, you don't have to file your taxes.
She thinks that there's a low level of income that makes it where you don't have to file your taxes. Is that true?
Yes, there is. There is. So take, for instance, if a person is on Social Security, let's say, or some other program, they do not have to file because they are not making enough money. But if you're making $10,000, you're making $12,000, you know, you should file. You should file because and you can file for free. You don't have to pay someone to do that. It is just puts you in a position when things like this, when you have programs like this come up, then you can apply.
So in other words, even though your niece only makes $12,000 a year, she should go ahead and file at least her 2019 and 2020. That way she'll get this check, any other kind of programs that she becomes eligible for. She won't owe money, so it won't hurt her to do it. And those, when you make that kind of money, the tax forms are really easy. You can literally yeah. file a form called EASY.
The 1040 EASY.
Gloria, you there? You got it? I guess we lost Gloria. So unless you're on assistance, in other words, because Carl from Culver City called, he couldn't stay on the phone. He wanted to know if people with disabilities who get, people who are on disability or on Social Security are going to get that $600 from the state.
They're going to get the $600 and they don't necessarily have to file because they're already in the system.
Okay, so they're already in the system. They don't have to file taxes, is that what you're saying?
They don't have to file taxes, yes.
Okay, but if you're a low wage earner, even if you're making $10,000, you should still file, and you will get that money.
Right, to be on the safe side, you should file. If you work in a seasonal job, you should file. You should file because you may be getting money back.
And you probably feel like I ask you this every single time, but I'm going to keep doing it. If I get the $600 from the state or the $1,400 from the feds, do I have to pay it back? Is it now going to pop up as money I owe somewhere on my taxes or in disability or taken out of some other check?
No. You pay money on income you earn. And that is not earned income. So
okay.
The monies that you have to pay taxes on is money like unemployment. If you received unemployment, you will get a 1099-G from the state. You have to pay unemployment from the IRS. You have to pay taxes on that.
Right, you pay taxes on unemployment, and maybe if you, had an inheritance, you might pay taxes on that, or if you win on The Price is Right, you're going to pay taxes on that.
you definitely will.
But you're not going to pay taxes on a COVID relief check.
No, and you're not going to pay any taxes on COVID relief, because that's money that the state or the government gave to you as a relief and not as earned income.
All right. So so you were about to say something about seniors.
So
seniors
if you're
and
a
the
senior,
$600. Yeah.
So if you're a senior, let's say, you don't have to file taxes if you're receiving social security, because you don't have to file because already you are in the system.
Okay.
So you don't have to file to get your $600 from the state.
Got it. All right. So then I know we were kind of switching gears to business. You said that it's not just the individuals that are not up to date on their taxes. A lot of us are running our side hustles, our small business, even medium-sized businesses like restaurants and flower stores or whatever, and we're not in compliance with our tax stuff.
Yes, because they may file their taxes, but there is something called a Schedule C. It is pretty much a profit and loss. If you have a business, you need to file a Schedule C every year along with your taxes. If you are sole proprietor, you need to file your Schedule C, and your Schedule C will say, okay, it's Brian Flower Shop, and Brian Flower Shop made $1,600 last year. And out of that $1,600, he made a profit of $31, or he made a profit of $1,500. But you need to show that, and you may not owe any taxes on that flower shop, but at least you are saying, hey, I have a business.
And so that if there are any benefits for businesses, of which there often are, you would become eligible. As long as we're doing it bootleg style and trying to go underground with our business, we don't get any benefits that accrue to small businesses. So
right. We think we're playing the government. We think we are hiding. But yes, probably we are hiding for a while. But whenever situations like COVID comes up, then we cannot take advantage of it, because the first thing you are asked to do, whether or not it is a grant from the state, whether or not it is a relief packet from the federal government, the first thing that is being asked for is your taxes. So a lot of people don't want to file their taxes, or don't want the government to know that they are making money on their side hustle. But the first time the government say, hey, we have a relief packet out, we cannot take advantage of it. So all the other businesses are taking advantage, and we are not.
Right. And it's, I mean, honestly, you can get someone to do it for you. It's not that you have to suddenly know tax law. Okay, let's go to Justin calling us from Ontario. Good morning, Justin.
Good morning. Thank you again for the show, Dominique.
Oh, thank you for calling.
Yeah, I know this might sound redundant. I just want to make sure that I called last week about probably the same thing, but I just want to make sure I get a firm understanding of what I need to do.
All good.
In terms of why the information is here. So, like, for example, I have an LLC and I have the small business. But, I'm a college student, so I didn't get a chance to file taxes on any of them, but I filed my personal taxes. And I was hoping that I could, because I didn't get a stimulus check or anything.
So you filed your personal taxes, but you didn't file your business taxes. You didn't get the first stimulus check, and you feel like it's because you didn't file business taxes. But you should have gotten the stimulus anyway.
I didn't get the $1,200. I didn't get, and I was working too. I didn't get the $1,200. I didn't get the city. I didn't get anything.
Unless you're making more than $60,000, right? Or $75,000, I think it is.
$75,000.
Yeah.
Dominic, he said he's a college student.
I'm sorry, say again, Marie.
He said he's a college student.
Yes.
The only way he would not get the stimulus if someone else is claiming him, so let's say his mom is claiming him or his dad is claiming him, that's one reason why he may not have gotten the stimulus.
Well, if you're
I received the email because I filed an H&R Block, and they sent me an email saying that it was supposed to post on my Emerald card, but it never came.
Okay, so they told you were getting it and you never got it. So you're not being claimed by someone else on their taxes. It sounds like there could be some kind of mix-up. I mean, that might be worth following up on.
It's difficult to get through to those people right now. No doubt.
And do you have any advice for him on how he can try to get that money? If he, you know, they told him he was eligible, but he just never received it and never...
What he has to do is to call the IRS and get a transcript. Call the IRS and ask them for a transcript for the years that he thinks his taxes were filed. And it may turn out that those taxes were never filed.
They even said, you know, I even owe right now. I owe them like $700 right now. I just had them send an amendment to my employer so I can, because they were garnishing my wages from the state.
Yeah, the state doesn't play. So the state was garnishing you, but the feds never sent you that stimulus. So somebody has you in the system. That's crazy. Yeah, I know. It sounds like you may have to sit on the phone with the IRS. But back to your other issue, which is you filed your personal but not your business. It sounds like you need to get your business filing done. So if you make more than $30,000, you're not going to get the $600, but you should probably get it done anyway, because there are other programs like county programs, city programs, and federal programs. There's a bunch of new federal money coming out again. So it sounds like you need to get that done, right, Marie?
Yes. And he said he has his corporation. A lot of people go out and form a corporation because somebody told them, oh, they can get an EIN number, or they can build credit on an EIN number. That is false. If you have an EIN number, you have to file taxes every year for that EIN. So not only do you have to file your personal taxes, you have to file your EIN taxes. And not only that, if you have an EIN number and you are in the state of California, you have to register your business with the Franchise Tax Board, which means that you have to have, you know, articles of incorporation. And when you have your articles of incorporation, you have to pay the state $800 every year, whether or not your business made money.
Generally, is this a good time to salvage the company? Is there a possibility? I'm just trying to salvage the company if I can.
Is it worth it to you to pay $800 a year for your company, whether they make any money or not?
Well, if you are not making money, if you are not doing, you know, I mean, $600,000-$700,000 a year, what is the point having an LLC, or what is the point having a corporation?
So say that $600,000 or $700,000 a year. I mean, most of us don't make that on our companies. I'm sorry.
Right, but if you're making a lot of money on your as a sole proprietor, let's say you are a sole proprietor, you are doing business as yourself. You don't have to pay the state. You are doing business as yourself. But what happens, let's say you have a company, some company out there pays you money every year and, you know, or pays you money every month. You're making $200,000-$300,000 on your business. Then, yes, you need to file. You should get...
I got to take a break right here, but I want to finish up with Justin. Justin has an LLC. A lot of people do. He doesn't He's not making, he said he's not making $800 a year. Can he get rid of that LLC?
Yes. He can file his taxes and he can let the government know that this is his last taxes.
Okay, and, so he has to let that be known on his tax form that he's closing down that LLC. And it sounds to me from what Justin is saying, we've lost him, is that that's what he needs to do. He's not even making the $800 a year. He doesn't need that LLC to be eligible for paycheck protection or any other small business if he's operating as a small proprietor. He just needs a Schedule C on his personal taxes to show that he owns a business. It sounds like he needs to get rid of that because that's going to be more of an expense than a help at this point.
Right. It's more of a burden than anything else.
Got to take a break. All right. We'll be back. We're continuing our conversation with Marie Deary. If you're holding on, keep holding on. If you've got a question, don't be shy. 520-KJLH, 520-5554. Just add your area code, your Southern Cal area code on the front and talk to us. Let's figure it out. I need a dollar. You need a dollar. Let's get these dollars. It's Radio Free 102.3 KJLA.